This is a piece of music called E-flat English. I hope you enjoy it. It incorporates the written and the unwritten. Thank you.
Okay. Just recently, my daughter travelled with us for a couple of days, and we have a video in our van, and we got out Snow White. Well, we bought it, actually. And the most interesting thing I thought about the film was where it says they got married and lived happily ever after. And this next ballad for me has got a certain element about marriage in it. And it's a story of fairies. These are not gentle Victorian fairies that have been banished to the nursery. These are medieval, malevolent, nasty fairies. And they've enchanted this young man, and they're going to sell him off to hell because they have to pay a tithe every 7 years, and he's looking rather plump and likely. And so he's desperately interested in avoiding this. And he goes into the woods, which is kind of like one of those things that happens in ballads. People go into the woods, it's like going into yourself, maybe. And they always meet, well, he meets with a girl, and this girl is a redoubtable girl. She's been told not to go to the woods, so the first thing she's done is go to the woods. When they meet, as always in ballads, there is a sexual encounter. And afterwards, she asks his name and what he's doing there. And he explains about the fairies. And he says that if she wants to release him from this spell and have him for her own, she must go to this very deserted spot at midnight on Halloween. Why not? And she has to wait for the fairy court to ride by. And as they ride by on different color horses, he has to wait for the white horse, and the young man will be riding the white horse, and she has to grab him down off the horse and hang on to him. Whatever happens, she must hold on. And because what's going to happen is the fairies are going to turn him into all different images. There's snakes. What else have we got? Wild dogs. Fire. All things guaranteed to make you let go. It's a sort of like the film 1984, where they find whatever it is you're most frightened of. Well, it's that kind of thing. Whatever it is you're frightened of. And she must hold on to him, and if she holds on to him through all these different trials, he will eventually turn into the man she loves. Now, to me, that is a metaphor for marriage. And the song is in three parts, and the last part is the other woman, the woman scorned, the queen of the fairies, who gives a short resume of what she would have done had she known the outcome of the day. This is the wonderful story of Tam Lin.
as it fell out along the day, a hunting I did ride. There came a wind out of the north, and woe to me.
And knew she had him a while.